So I would love to ask the two of you a question. We've got quite a few women working in R&D, 36%, but it does kind of drop off as women get more senior. And a lot of them are not happy with the level of inclusiveness of the workplace. So I wonder what it works like for you in DSM and what you think really works and where you have some wishes of what we could do differently.
What I experienced during my career is that the way how you express things could be received in a different way. And what helped me a lot is that I had people who were encouraging me and who believed in me, because I tend to speak about things I need to improve on, my doubts, my insecurities, and that could be interpreted in the wrong way, like I don't want to make the next step.
I'm in the beginning of my career and I can see how it can be difficult to enter into a male-dominated science environment. What helps is that once you start seeing the hurdles, you start talking about it, and then there are always people that are helpful within DSM.
Inclusion is always was often easy in the good times when you discuss something in the meeting. Where it gets more tricky is when you get into conflict situations. Have you ever experienced stereotypes where you feel there's something going on now that that it gets a little more tricky and conflictual?
In general, I would say I'm used to work with males in meetings all the time. In a tough situation, the awareness is important, and showing the emotions. I personally experienced that was really coming from my heart. Turned out to go well. But what I learned during my career, I have to be selective when I show them and when I keep them for myself. And that's what you really have to balance to stay effective.
One of the things that we know from research again is that the role of men is actually really important in fostering gender diversity, gender equality in a business. So what message do you have to the men of DSM?
I would like to make it broader and not only look at gender, but also other diversity aspects like culture. And there, for me, the key message is we should increase the awareness of the impact of diversity in our communication style, and to make sure that what you send out is received in the right way.
Marcus, do you have any experience with the role of mentoring or coaching and how important that is in the context of what we're discussing today?
Years ago, I was mentoring a young female scientist, brilliant lady. She always had a great contribution to discussions or problem solving, but you always had to ask and encourage her. And we actually sent her out to a specific training to build self-confidence and be more proactive. And afterwards, she said, this training really opened my eyes, in that I always felt when I know something, somebody will ask me and then I will make the contribution. And I realize men react more actively to this. And since I made that switch, I'm now much more proactively offering what I can do. I realize there is a responsibility as leaders, as men, but also as coaches, to really enforce and help and trigger this. Have you had such experiences as well?
When I first started in DSM, I was very lucky to have actually a male mentor, because basically in that coaching environment, it is the environment that you can be yourself, it is safe, and you can be trusted. At that moment, you start understanding truly the perspective of the other. Now I know how the different thinking process works for my male colleagues, and that person knows how it works mm-hmm. for women. How about for you, Marianne?
Yeah, I have especially a good example with a female, small group of women, as you say, a very safe environment, becoming more aware of the kind of typical way of communicating of women or acting. And that awareness helped me to kind of more tune my communication and be more aware to get my message across.
What is the one or two things that you think we can do to make an impact at DSM?
I would like to bring this gender issue into this normal line. So it should be normalized. To get there, we should be aware of the unconscious biases that we have. We should talk about it, and only just by talking and communication, things will get better.
How about you?
Yeah, I would like to add to that, that we in the daily practice of DSM be more aware of the differences and take them into our daily conversations, meetings, next steps. And what also is very important is that if you talk about the gender thing, you give the females the time, the flexibility to develop their career in the way they want it.